Hello, welcome to the Metro Desk. My name is Mark Jacob. I'm a deputy Metro editor at the Chicago Tribune. On the Metro Desk, we look at the news of the day, talk to our reporters, and share with our readers what's happening and our viewers as well. One of the big stories on our front page this morning was about a dispute over a stadium in the suburbs, in the northwest suburbs. We have Robert McCoppin, one of our reporters, with us. Bobby, there?
Hi, Mark.
Hi. So explain to us this story a little bit. It's in Crystal Lake South, where they've built a brand new stadium for football, and I'm sure the football fans are really happy about that, but some other people are not so happy.
That's right. They built the new stadium this summer, and it's a lot bigger than the old one, and it's right next to the neighbors who live right next to the high school, and so they sued over this new stadium that's out, the new stands that are out there.
And it's obviously you have a lot of disputes like this, but this one has a kind of an interesting and sort of unique quality in that the school district built this stadium, replaced its stadium, without getting permission from the city, and without, it was a big surprise to the people who live next there, and the school district says it doesn't need the city's zoning permission in order to do this, right?
That's right. That's the argument out there, that school district says, well, we asked our regional school superintendent and we got permission from her to go ahead with this. But the city says, well, you got permission for the building, but you still need to go through the zoning process like everybody else does at the city.
And obviously this means a lot for home values and the people around there. There's in your story, it talks about it's a neighbor who says that people in the stands are looking down in at their house, and it's almost like they're being peeped at.
Yeah, the stands are like almost 50 feet tall, and they're about almost a couple hundred feet wide. So they're about triple the width that they used to be. And so the people who live next to there, they were used to having obviously a football stadium next to them. But they were not used to the size and scope of this thing. And it's a sheer metal wall, because now they don't have the gaps in the seats that they used to. And they have people looking down, they say, in their windows and yelling to them. But the legal question that could set precedent here is whether schools have to go to municipalities to go through their zoning process. Typically, schools do that. They work with cities come to some cooperative agreement. But in this case, the Attorney General has ruled that schools do have to submit to zoning process, and the Illinois State Board of Education agrees with that. But the school district 155 is going to fight this and see if they can get the go-ahead to keep the stadium as it is.
So one interesting argument that the city made, I thought, was the attorney said, well, that if the school can do whatever it wants in this place, there's nothing to stop them from building a NASCAR track, which was kind of a colorful argument.
But if they don't need city permission, then they could build whatever they want, regardless of their neighbors. But the school said, well, of course we wouldn't do that. We're just here to pursue our mission of teaching students, and that's what the regional superintendent has oversight for, to make sure that they would build only legitimate purposes.
So this is back in court next month, and is it conceivable they would have to tear down the new stadium they built?
It's possible. There's McHenry County judge is going to rule on it next month. That would seem to be an extreme solution. It cost $1 million, over $1 million to put this up. Maybe they, elsewhere they have, when there's been disputes between neighbors and schools, they have formed a citizens committee to work with the schools and maybe come up with some compromise, relating to the lighting or the noise, or maybe they can, like with, the new Sox park, well, it's not new anymore, but they reconfigured the stadium a little bit to make it a little more, in that case, fan-friendly, and maybe they can make it a little more neighbor-friendly.
Okay. Okay, thanks, Robert. So the Tribune will be following this story, so stay tuned here. Thanks for your report, Robert, and for the story in this morning's paper.
Thank you.
Very interesting story that may have implications beyond one town in McHenry County.
Right.
We also wanted to talk to a business reporter, Mary Ellen Podmolik, who has another story about development that's certainly not like the stadium story out in the burbs. This is right downtown, and in fact, across from Tribune Tower. We're talking about the Realtors building. Tell us about the story.
Well, the National Association of Realtors is moving forward with a plan to consider tearing down their building at 430 North Michigan Avenue and replacing it, the building behind that building that they own, and then also a whole nother block behind that with what could be an $800 million to $1 billion project. But that's not what a lot of people are concerned about so much. What people really seem to be concerned about is what happens to the Billy Goat Tavern, which is underneath Michigan Avenue.
Right, it's in lower Michigan.
Right. Right.
It is so interesting because, from a big picture perspective, this is a development that may stretch blocks all the way from Michigan to Wabash, right? And with condos, offices, a hotel possibly, and could take 5 years to develop. But everyone's focused on, a little piece of Chicago history right there in lower Michigan. So what's going to happen to the Billy Goat?
Well, if you talk to Sam Sanos, who I went down and talked to yesterday, and he said he knew nothing about this. There has been a proposal, there's been talk floated around that the Billy Goat actually could move directly across the street to the bottom of the Wrigley building and the basement there. And in fact, the gentleman I talked to for the National Association of Realtors said there is an overpass that if you're going, going towards the lake right by Billy Goat, there's a sign that says, Billy Goat Tavern, and there's like a hand pointed this way. And he said, well, just move the hand the other way right there. The interesting thing of it is, while the partner for the project is not named, it is widely believed to be BDT Capital Partners, which owns the big block behind it that would be part of this. They also bought the Wrigley building. And so it kind of would make sense that it's all one big happy family, just move Billy Goat across the street. A lot of people don't like this idea because, how can you move even the history? If you move all the chairs and the tables and everything else, it's still not where it has been now for 49 years. Next year will be 50 years to that location.
But so at least in theory, they would take all the yellowed newspaper clippings off the wall.
I'm not sure what would happen to some of those clippings when you pull them off the wall. But yeah, theoretically, it is one thing under discussion because Sam says he does not want to be part of a fancy new building. And anything they build there obviously would look a little more updated than what Billy Goat looks like
right
now.
And the floors might not be as sticky, possibly, and
not immediately.
That's have you been hearing from readers? Has there been kind of an outcry about people who are really worried about it?
There has been a lot of outcry. It's fascinating. I mean, as we pointed out in our story today, the Billy Goat draws tourists as well as locals, and the story seems to have struck a chord with a lot of people locally and across the nation. The bigger picture, as you alluded to, is this, huge development that really kind of shows how North Michigan Avenue has changed. Mm-hmm. The center of it, it used to be all the activity was up on the north end. Now the very south end of the Mag Mile, just north of the river, is a really hot place to be. And, you look in the later part of the 90s when the Nordstrom Mall was just getting developed, and that took a long time to get developed. Mm-hmm. But that also stretches from Michigan Avenue all the way back to,
right to Wabash,
and is a huge moneymaker for the city now with what they put in there.
Right, and you see the traffic in this area, downtown is so big, tourist traffic.
Right.
Increased traffic from places like, tourism from places like China. You see a lot of Chinese and international tourists too.
Right.
I don't know whether they'd be as interested in the Billy Goat, but it is a
everybody's interested in the Billy Goat.
It is a piece of Chicago.
At least once.
Yeah, and it is so stuck in time that I think people worry that moving it could not keep it the same.
Right.
So do the developers have some sort of job to do selling it to the Sanos family?
Well, it's not just selling to the Sanos family. I mean, they're going to have to sell this to the city because there obviously would have to be a lot of changes. A very early rendering, not on the Michigan Avenue block, but on the block directly to the west of it, an early rendering showed a 93-story building. That's going to be a big sell to the city. Certainly what's on that lot now is a parking lot and the former Lakeshore Athletic Club, which has been closed for many years. But to do something of this scale, they're talking somewhere between 1 million and 2 million square feet. From the realtor's standpoint, their building now is fully, it's utilized well. They want to try and make accommodations for all the different tenants in that building. But with that presence right on Michigan Avenue, I mean, that's a gold mine from a real estate standpoint, and they want to do the best they can for it. And the one other sticking point in all this is the realtors who do not have a final development agreement with a partner. It's all very preliminary. One of their demands is it has to be somewhere branded on Michigan Avenue that it's a realtor's building. Realtors. If it says realtors, if it says a big R, what have you. Because if you see right now, you go out there, it says realtor building in pretty big letters across the street from us.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, you'll be following this.
I certainly will.
A lot of people who love the Billy Goat and are interested in North Michigan Avenue will be paying great attention. Thanks so much for being with us today. So that's it for the Metro Desk today. Thanks for tuning in. Come back. We like to discuss the news of the day from perspective of our reporters and our editors. Thank you so much for joining us today.